डियर फ्रेंड्स नमस्कार, आई एम डॉक्टर नूतन प्रकाश फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, आत्मीय यूनिवर्सिटी राजकोट। सो दिस वीडियो इज इन द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द ब्लास्ट पार्ट टू, इन विच आई एक्सप्लेन्ड द बेसिक्स ऑफ द ब्लास्ट एंड द इंटरफेस ऑफ द ब्लास्ट। So in that video, we have discussed that how you can use the NCBI BLAST and what are the different versions of the BLAST. And in this particular segment, I am going to teach you, give you the hands-on training that if you have any certain problem, how you will be able to solve with the using the BLAST. So let's check it out. Here in this video, we are going to address two questions. The question number one is, say for example, I have one question, I have one unknown protein and I want to know the function of this particular protein, or I want to know about this particular protein, that whether someone have already identified it or not. Say for example, any scientists have gone through sequencing, right? They have isolated the protein, purified the protein, and they gone through the sequencing, and now they come up with the question that this particular sequence. Now you want to identify that what is the name of this particular protein, what is the function of this particular protein, all these you want to explore. So without moving into wet lab, how you can do? So the simple solution is, if we apply the rule of homology, means if your sequence is matching with the showing the high level identity or similarity with any other sequence which function is already known, then we can assign the function of your unknown protein. So how do we do that? Because if you go on the, I have already explained in another videos, like how to retrieve the protein sequences from the SwissProt, like UniProt. In UniProt, there is the two database, SwissProt and Trimble. So if you go on the UniProt website, you will find that more than 6 lakh wet lab sequences are there. So is it possible for you to match this unknown sequence with each and every sequences, like 6 lakh protein sequences? Then you will conclude, okay fine, which protein is actually showing the maximum level of similarity? Definitely it is very time consuming, and it will slow your research. So the simple solution of it, if you use the BLAST, and obviously in this case you have what, you have protein sequence. So protein is a query and you want to match it with the protein sequence which is deposited into database. So the simple logic is, if this query is matching with the another sequence which is already annotated in the database, then you can identify this protein and the function of this particular protein. So simply we can use the BLAST, and specifically we can use the BLAST P version, means protein BLAST. So how we can do that? You have two ways. The number one is, there is two way to use the BLAST. Number one, I told you, like the BLAST, this one, open the NCBI and here you find the BLAST. Okay, let me open it. It depends on your internet speed. So here with a single click I found the web BLAST, 4 type of options. So which one I should use? I can use the protein BLAST. Then whatever protein sequence have been given to me, that simply I can copy in the FASTA format. You know the FASTA format, it starts with the greater than sign and the short description, and then from the new line the amino acid sequences itself. So let me copy this, okay, and that protein sequence in the FASTA format I can copy it and paste it here. And since I want to use all the sequences, amino acid bases in my sequence similarity, so here I am keeping the from and to, is everything is blank. And here job title, if you want you can, otherwise you can leave it, no problem. And from the database, from which database you want to match with, so here I am putting the UniProt so that I can get the wet lab sequence, because you know in the SwissProt there is the manually annotated protein sequences are there, so you will get the better annotation. You will get the better idea about the function and identification of your protein. So what I do, I just select the SwissProt and let me click on the blast. Once you will click on the blast, it will take 1 or 2 minutes, depends on the internet speed and the load on the server. So you will get the results, and results will be like this one only. I have already done it and I have got the results to save the time. So here I am going to tell you how to interpret the result which was given by blast. So here you see the program name was blast. If you are writing any particular research paper, then you can give the citation to blast. See, this is the references you can put to the blast, which database you used. Obviously you have searched against the SwissProt. So here you see that how many number of sequences were there, how many number of sequences there in the SwissProt sequence up to 14th of September 2020. So it is around 474,714 sequences. So your sequence matched with 474,714 sequences, and that blast have given the results. Here you see how many results it is showing. 100, top 100 results it gives you. Since description I have not written, the query ID something by default it takes, the molecule type is amino acid, query length the whatever unknown amino acid sequence you have been given, that have the query length is 422. Okay, fine. So now here you can see the description, the graphic summary, the alignment and the taxonomy. So there is this the result. So now let me show you how to interpret the result of it. So if I click on the description, here you see what is the meaning of the description. In the description, see here it is select all. Okay, now it is none of them sequence have been selected. It is by default like that only. So here you can see that this is the protein sequence, severe acute respiratory syndrome, SARS, right? It is the sequence of SARS. And if I click on here, then I will find the coronavirus. So this is the protein sequence. Your query protein sequence is matching with the nucleoprotein of, here you can see the nucleoprotein of coronavirus, SARS coronavirus. How much it is matching? It is matching 98.82%. Means your unknown protein is nothing. This is the one nucleoprotein, and it is matching with the SARS coronavirus. And this is, if you know about this sequence in detail, about the function and all, if I click on this particular SSN number, it will be, and I already discussed about the integration with other databases. So if I click on this open link in new tab, I will get each and everything about the nucleoprotein of SARS coronavirus. So within a single click, now I identified that whatever protein sequence I got, this is the unknown protein, that is nothing, that is what, that is nucleoprotein. It is matching with the SARS-CoV-2. So why it is 98.82%, not it is 100%, it is not 100%, it is matching only 98.82%, means somewhere there is the difference of something like 1.18%. So if you want to see that, where is the difference, because in this particular window you will not find anything. So what I do, just click on this one. Let me click on it. See what is going to happen. Once I click on it, see the first result, the top result is the most significant result. Here you can find the the identity is out of 422 amino acid, your protein is matching with 417, means it differ from the novel like coronavirus, it is differing 5 amino acids. So where it is difference, so that also you can find. See here, if I see that at this particular position your query have K, but SARS coronavirus have Q, right? So this is the difference number one. Let me find another differences. So here you have to just check manually where is the differences. I think 4 to 5 positions it should have the difference. Yes, more difference you can see here. Here I find that in this your query have M, but at that particular position your database sequence have K. You have V, but that coronavirus have H. All right, So there is the difference. So three differences we find out. More differences, you if you manually just check it out, you will find the differences. All right. So there is, I think, all right. So identity is 417 and total is 422. Means out of 422, your protein is exactly matching at 417. At 5 position, it is differing from the novel SARS coronavirus. All right. Here you can see another difference. Here in this position, you have the glutamate, but that coronavirus have the aspartate. So this is the first way. If I want to go back, what was my result? So if I again click over the descriptions, you see here in the descriptions, with another protein sequence, my protein is matching 96.62%. So again, it is nucleocapsid protein. See, nucleocapsid protein from the bat SARS coronavirus. All right. So I think the first result is the most significant. One more thing, while you go through the blast, one more thing you have to keep remember always, that is the E value. E value means what is the chance of, what is the by chance expected value. Here I am telling you, if the value is, E value is zero, means it is most significant. There is no doubt in the homology. And if it is between 1e minus 3 to 0, it is significant. If it is, it was written here 1, 2 or 3 or 4 or 5, it was not significant. Although BLAST have given the result, but you don't have to consider it in your research. So how you will justify your result? Since the E value in the permissible range, that is 1e minus 3 to 0, then your result is significant. All right. So that was the first way. Once you have the protein sequence, that protein sequence you can copy and you can put over the NCBI. Another way, if you don't want to use the NCBI BLAST, then one more option you have. What another option? You can open the UniProt, the uniprot.org. Here again you may find the BLAST. But the difference is, on the NCBI you will find all the BLAST, like BLAST, nucleotide BLAST, protein BLAST, T-BLAST and T-BLASTX and all, but in the UniProt you will find only the protein BLAST. So if you have the protein sequence and you want to match up with the protein sequence, then both the options available with you. Either you can go on the NCBI or you can go on the UniProt. So if I want to use the BLAST of UniProt, result you are going to get almost same. So if I click on the BLAST, see, if I click on the BLAST, so very simple interface. Here again I can put my paste my sequence which was been given in the PPT, right? Yes, I have copied and pasted, and simply here you can see whether you want to match it with the SwissProt. So simply without doing anything, what I can do, I can click on the run BLAST. After a few seconds or few minutes, depends on the internet speed and the server load, it will display the result like this way. See the result. So how much result it is giving to you? Like from the SwissProt, total 64 sequences are matching, and from the UniProt, it is unreviewed, means from the Trimble, it is showing 69. So suppose once I have the wet lab sequences, then definitely I don't have to give the importance to a dry lab sequence, right? The computer generated. So I want to show you here, just only I want to match my protein sequence with a reviewed one, means the sequences from the SwissProt. So it will be better for you. So now you can see, now you see the result. Here is the color you can see, right? If your sequence is matching with the database sequence with 100%, so that result will be like this is the color scheme. So just watching just color, you will come to know that how much percent your sequence, your query sequence is matching with the database. All right. And if you want to see that how many percentage it is showing the identity, it is 98.8%. As already mentioned in the BLAST result on the NCBI, there was also result with the 98.8%, right? And see, and it is matching with the human SARS coronavirus. So once you have the protein sequence, you can get in the UniProt, in the better way, you can get the results. And it is bit faster also. So what I recommend you, once you have the protein to search for, you can use the UniProt. And once you have the nucleotide sequences, you can go for the on the NCBI BLAST, the nucleotide BLAST. Each and everything will be same, the E value and all, everything will be same. So there is no difference. So it doesn't matter whether you have the protein sequence or you have the nucleotide sequence. If you have the nucleotide sequence with you, you don't have any option. You have to go on the NCBI. And if you have the protein sequence you want to search with, then you can go on the UniProt or you can search on the NCBI protein blast. I'll use both. In both the cases, you will find the almost same result. And if you want to know that where is the difference, so see here the interface is better in the UniProt, right? So E value is 0, score is something, identity is 98.8%. What is the score and all that I will explain in classroom. And if I want to see the alignment, right? So if I click on the view alignment, see what I'm going to get the results. So you will get all the details. See, it's a, I think it's better. So you have got the results that it is 98.8% positives, like query match is 422. And where is the difference that you have to manually find out? Just in the case of the NCBI blast, see here in the your query it is K, and but the SARS coronavirus have Q in this particular position. You have L, but this one have the S. All right. So there is the two changes, total 5 changes you have to find out. That manually you have to search it out. Okay. You have to manually inspect where is the difference. See, 2 is there, and M and V here you again find. Again you find. So there is total 4. One more you have to find somewhere. There is the differences. So total 5 differences are there. Okay. So that's how you will be able to identify that whatever protein sequence you got, that you can identify that which protein, what type of protein it is and what is the function of it. If I click on this particular P95 something, then I will get each and everything about that nucleoprotein. So I will come to know the function of this particular protein. Now let me elaborate the another example. Say for example, in your examination or in your research, you have another type of problem in which protein sequence have been not given, right? What is being asked here? Identify the most homologous protein sequence of human insulin protein. Here, there is no any instruction that where is the sequence, how you will find the sequences, from where you have to retrieve this particular sequence. Nothing have been given. So means indirectly, what you have to do, you first have to retrieve the insulin protein sequence. So how you can retrieve, you can how to retrieve the protein insulin insulin protein from the database, for that one you have, you can refer my previous video which was based on the UniProt. So what I do here, I just open uniprot.org so that I can retrieve the insulin protein sequence. So how I can do the query, the specific query here, the search. Here I can put the insulin. First I want the insulin protein, right? So what I do here, I type insulin, and here I can put the name of protein description, protein name insulin, and of course for human being I want. So here I can put on the all, I can put the organism. So I will find the protein sequence. See, this much result I got. I got 60 result from the database from the SwissProt and 137 result from the Trimble. So if I click on the review, so it is going to show me only and only the sequence from the wet lab. All right. So here now I have to manually, since I think out of 60 to identify your protein is not a difficult task. Just simply come to know that this is your protein, right? This is the protein. So if I click on this one, insulin protein of human being will be open. Now protein sequence is with you, but it did not find any sequence here, right? So if you want to see the protein sequence here, because a lot of descriptions have been given, annotations on all, but you, here you mean you need only sequence, right? If you want to see the sequence of insulin protein sequence, so what you can do, there is a lot of options to display. You can put the FASTA, see, you can put the format, and you can put the FASTA canonical. So you will find the sequence, see, that is displayed. All right. So this is the FASTA sequence of your insulin protein. Now I want to match, now I want to know that which one is the most homologous protein sequence of human being. So what I can do, I have two options. Either I can copy that particular format, that FASTA format, I can go on the NCBI, then I perform the BLASTp. And once you have the working with the protein, you have two options. Either you can copy and go on the NCBI, or if you want to be here only, you have inbuilt option of the BLAST here. I just simply click on the BLAST, see. You don't have to copy paste and you have to go anywhere. Once it is the protein, right? Simply, what is done? What have been done? BLAST is automatically running. So I have to search it out the most homologous protein of human, right? So obviously the difference, there will be a different organism, which amino acid sequence, which insulin is homologous to our protein sequence, right? So again, since the it depends on your internet speed and servers load, it may take 1 minute or 2 minutes or more than that also. So for the until result is not being displayed, we have to wait. So once you are getting the result, you have to take care, you have to take care of two things. The first one is the e value should be in the permissible range, number one, and your query coverage will be very good. Okay, so here you see the result from my protein sequence is matching with the SwissProt. It's a 57 result I got, so I want to display that only. Yeah, so here you see the result. Here you see the insulin, it is showing insulin homo sapiens, no? So why it is, and it is showing high, and it is how much? 100% means what? And it is 100% means what? Since that protein sequence I have taken from the SwissProt and it is matching with the SwissProt only, then definitely insulin of homo sapiens is going to match with the homo sapiens only. So definitely means it is going to be 100%. So obviously this is not the answer, because your query protein was the homo sapiens, right? So this is not the answer. Answer is something else. Answer is number two. You see, the insulin of gorilla, right? The trinomial nomenclature. So here your protein sequence is matching 100% with the gorilla. There is not a single amino acid difference. So if I want to see that, I can click on the second one, view alignment, and I will find the alignment, the detailed alignment. Here you see the E value is 1.8 e minus 7.7 you see here. And it is 100% and E value is -77, means it's okay. It's a very good result because it is in the permissible range of 0 to 1 E minus 3. 1 E minus 3, 1 E minus 100, 1 E minus 500, all are good. But 1 E minus 2 is not correct, right? So the value should be between 0 to 1 E minus 3. 1 E minus 4, 1 E minus 10, 1 E minus 100, 1 E minus 1000, everything will work. And 0, if it is 0, then best. You find out here. You got 100% alignment, means our human insulin protein sequence is matching with gorilla's insulin 100%. So now you have solved two type of problem. The number one problem, once protein sequence have been given to you and it is unknown, you want to identify which type of protein it is, that you can do with the help of the BLAST. And number two, once you have the protein sequence and name and everything with you, and you want to find out that your protein is matching with which organism's protein, so that kind of the answer you also may get from the BLAST. So I think now you are skilled that how to use the BLAST. Hope it helps you. And thank you very much. If you like the video, you press like and subscribe the video so that next time once I upload any kind of the video, you can get the notification. Thank you.